2,000 years after the departure of Jesus the Christ. The prophets are back to teach the real Jews, the 12 tribes of Israel, their true nationality. This is their campaign.
Yeah, I'm charging you to get right, black man. I'm charging you to. I don't care what you went through. Repentance is for what you went through, brother. So you may repent and change your way of life. I don't care what you went through. You should not care what I went through. I'm here now, preaching repentance, brother. Let the past be the past. Now let's focus in the future. How do we build these black men to be leaders? How do we build our black woman to act like woman today? To be a woman. You understand? There's a bunch of single sisters out here. How do we bring that black man back to take responsibility as a father? You understand? That's what we're preaching out here. That we deem of the black man, brother. That we deem of the Israelite man. That we deem that Christ come and giving us on earth, man. He died for us. So we have to wake the hell up, man. We cannot be out here drugs, on drugs, heroin, crack. Smoking a lot of weed out here talking about you in the spirit world. You bug out your damn mind.
Exodus chapter 20, verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Yeah, Egypt means the house of bondage, meaning captivity, brother. That's all it means, all right? Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
That means the Lord going to bring us into captivity again. We just left Egypt under captivity. But there was a prophecy, we're going to brought up into captivity again. Let's see which captivity we brought up under. Listen to this.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
How do we brought up in America, brothers and sisters? We brought up in cargo slave ship. Moses already prophesied 1,000 years ago that how the Israelite going to brought up in cargo slave ship. And in case you are thinking that your transportation was just willing transportation, the prophecy is that you know Israel was going to brought up in cargo slave ship in America. How did we brought up in America? Cargo slave ship. Let's read it again.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
Yeah, how did we brought up in America? Cargo slave ship. It's prophesying the Bible for you and I to wake up when we read things like that. We in Babylon. We're in the worst place, but the most powerful kingdom on earth. That don't mean that America is the righteous kingdom on earth, but America was established for us as a people to recognize and say, whoa, if God can bring us here, God can do anything. Because of our sin, we brought up in America, so we can get our mind right. But we become Americanized. You call them the American dream. The American dream come with a price. So the Bible said that children of Israel was going to brought up in cargo slave ship to America. How do you come here? Cargo slave ship. How do you come here, sir? Cargo slave ship. How do I get to Haiti? Cargo slave ship. How do you get here? Cargo slave ship. So the Bible is giving it the history of the Israelite. Who you are today? You call yourself maybe Afro-American. I call myself Haitian. You might call yourself Afro-American. You might call yourself Jamaican. You have a title. But you are the children of Israel. Lift that up for me. This is what God said you are. You see, now they changed your name under slavery. Your masters changed your name to these things here. You understand? But your biblical name is this. If you're black American, you're from the tribe of Judah, which is the mighty tribe Christ come out. If you are a Jamaican, you're from the tribe of Benjamin. If you are a Haitian, you come from the tribe of Levi, which is Moses would have called himself a Haitian today. You understand? But you are coming from the most greatest people in the planet Earth that ever existed. They go here in America, we bug out our mind. In Christianity, we bug out our mind. In Islam, we bug out our mind. In Buddha, we bug out our mind. In any type of religion. Moses never give us religion, man. Let's see what Moses, hold on to that. Give me Deuteronomy 4 and 44. Moses never give us religion. How the hell we bug around here with religion? You have to wake up, black man. Wake up. Religion was created right after we coming out of slavery. The white man want us to come because our mindset was to pay back whatever we went through. Then he give you the religion. Then he read the Bible to you in a way that he want you to read it. You understand talking about God forgive and forget. But forgive and forget. But then you talking about forgive and forget. So you told me God forgive this and God forgive what the white man has done? You telling me that let me see slavery. Where's the other thing? Yeah, let me see that thing. You tell me. Yeah, hold on, brother. Brother, you telling me nobody gonna pay for this? Until this condition we are today is a fact. Post that. You tell me God is looking down and let the white man go free for what he did to our people, to his people? Y'all gonna tell your mind then. Y'all thinking God's gonna pay the person that do this? Black man, if you see a white kid, right? Let's see a white kid was hanging here. He just see a murder. He said see a murder. You know they give him therapy? But us, who have offered us therapy for this? We still bug out our mind to the day. Who have offered us therapy for this?
Right.
Look at that black man today. Black man 26, lost all his teeth. You understand? Now realize that I just put you in the spot out of love, brother. Don't look at it like that. You understand? Like us, we bugged out our mind. We was in this world. But the Lord God is going to pay whoever did this to us.
Right.
Yeah. That's our time now to refresh our mind. That's what Christ said this. Give me that, I know man, I'm jumping. Give me that woman 12 and 2. That's what God said this. Pay attention. Because somebody have to pay for this, man. Look at that black man. Almost butt naked selling a slave. Well, what's that called, that slave? Slave what?
Slave auction.
A slave auction. And you think nobody gonna pay for this? Then the white man look at us now. We have to move on. We have to move on. We have to move on after all you had done. It's still affected to the day. Look how many 80% of our black men in jail because of these things, man. Because of low self-esteem. Our black men has not stand up and take responsibility for being a black man on earth. You have to take responsibility for your kids, your wife, hey, your children.
That's right.
Yes. Look at that. Black men in suits. Who's gonna pay for this? Who the hell is gonna pay for this? Y'all better wake up, man. Y'all better wake up and notice that the white man is your enemy. Always remember that. All that nation is your enemy. Not only him. All nation is your enemy. Go ahead.
Romans chapter 12, verse 2. And be.
I'm gonna back that up. The Chinese man, when he come in their community, build these stores. Do he invest back in your community? The Arab, when he come and invest, do he invest it back to the community?
No.
So they're taking all our wealth out. And they turn around, you see these guys? They're savage. They're drug dealers. But you take all that business out.
Yeah.
You take all that wealth out. All of them are your enemies, man. All these nations are our enemies. Who come in our community, build up shop, to invest back to their community. They are your enemy. They're not your friend. They never will. They was born to be your enemy. That's why you guys don't understand. Go ahead.
Romans chapter 12 verse 2. And be not conformed to this world.
What Christ said?
Be not conformed to this world.
What Christ said?
Be not conformed to this world.
What about the American dream, brother? I mean, that's a lie then. Go ahead.
Be not conformed to this world.
Mosiah said, be not conformed to this world. What this world offer, brother? Democracy, education, and religion. We're not supposed to be a part of that, being an Israelite. That has nothing to do with us. We're waiting for our Savior to come, Christ Almighty. He's coming to conquer the world. But we have to have our mind right. The 12 tribe must, our mind must be right. We have to transform our mind. Go ahead.
Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.
You see what our mind has to become, brothers and sisters? Our mind must be renewed. Renew to what? God's commandments. You have women walk around here with pins. That's against God's commandments. You have sisters walk around here being a lesbian. That's against God's commandments. You got brother being a homosexual. That's against God's commandments. You have brothers being a paper hustler. That's against God's commandments.
Right.
Your mind must be renewed. God created you to be a woman. That's what God created you to be. A woman,
right.
Not a man.
Right.
God did not make a mistake. Your lust has conquered you. God did not make a mistake. God created you to be a woman, so be a woman. God created you to be a man, so be a man. God did not create for you to be a homosexual lesbian. America did. All these lusts America has created for you. Then you falling what into that trench? They're talking about, I was born gay. Show me in the scripture where a man was born gay. And if you cannot show it to me, shut the hell up.
That's right.
Shut the hell up.
That's right.
Go ahead.
And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.
So what mind you have now? You have the mind of America. Where the Bible says your mind must be refreshed. Your mind must be renewed. What mindset you have? That's okay to be a homemonger. Leave our woman, single parents out here. That's okay for the abortion clinic to be in our community. The drugs, the alcohol. Your black men don't stand up. Your black men don't stand up because you're weak. You're a bunch of weak black men. When you gonna stand up for your community and stand up and be a man? Because you're weak. But this is your day today. Today is your day to bring back the black man and the Spanish man and his white form, being a man again. Take responsibility. That's right.
But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good and what is acceptable in the perfect will of God.
You know why our mind must be renewed? We may prove what is good in the sight of God. We have not know what is good in the sight of God. We think homosexual, that men born like that. Or lesbian born like that. We thought that a guy that sold drug, he was born like that. That's a lie. That's a lie. These are the condition of our people in our community. That's why they create this abortion clinic. Jails is being built every day for the black men and the Spanish men. Because you don't know who you are. But I'm here to tell you, you are the most important people in this planet Earth. You understand? You are the son and daughters of Zion. You are the sons of the living God. So you better understand that. You are the son of the living God. Why your community is like that? You need to ask yourself the question, Spanish man.
Right.
And black brothers, you need to ask yourself a question. Are we standing up for this community? Why are young men become homosexual? Why are young women become lesbian?
Right.
Is that Americanized? They've been Americanized. According to the Bible, it's a sin. According to God's laws, it's a sin. So you must renew your mind. You must. How the hell we have all these drug dealers in our neighborhood? We're going to clean the neighborhood. Because we don't have no spirit of fear of no man. You come to our neighborhood and sell drugs, you better pay for whatever gonna come after. You understand? There won't be no drug dealers in our neighborhood. When we stand up in the right spirit of Christ, because we know that it's more with us than you. We have angels surrounding us. I wonder who you have with you. Go ahead.
Romans chapter 12, verse 2. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.
You see me why our mind have to transform? Because let me show you. Let me show you. The Bible said, let's go back to the Acts one more time. Because the world said, the Bible is for always a people. I'm going to show why I might have to be with you. I'm going to show you something. I'm going to show you something. Sister, I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you're here. Now, she's just here to listen. That's all right. That's all right. She's our sister. Before she turned like that, she was still our sister. You understand? Before we turned to be the drug dealer, the pimp, we were still a family in the neighborhood. But we have destroyed our community, black men. It's time now to go back and clean down the neighborhood. That's what we are about, sister. The redeem of the black woman, the redeem of the black man. And if you're not about that, you just confused, like the rest of the nation are. Go ahead.
Acts chapter 5, verse 29. Then Peter and the other apostles said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
Who are we going to obey? God rather than men, right? You're going to find out you have obeyed men all your life. The white men say, John 3:16, God so loved the world. He sent his only begotten son. So whosoever believe in him shall receive life. But who world is referring to, black men? The world of the Israelites.
That's right.
It's not referring to all people. That's how you know that you've been taught wrong all your life.
Right.
You've been taught the white man was superior than you.
Right.
You've been taught that the Spanish man was, no, not the Spanish man, the Arab dude was more superior than you.
Right.
The so-called African woman was superior than you. We here to tell you, you're more superior than all race of people in the planet Earth.
That's right.
You understand? You're not in the bottom. You're supposed to be in the top. Right now you're in the bottom. Why are you in the bottom? Because you're still in your sin. Because you're still in your sin. You know a woman not supposed to wear pants is a sin? To show you the mindset you've been Americanized. Now it's time for you to take that pants off, put a beautiful dress, skirt on, fringes on, act like a woman. Tattoo is against God's laws too. If you have tattoo on, you need to stop doing any more tattoo. Repent out of that. Stop doing tattoo. It's against God's commandment. If you want to know why you're in the condition you're in, sister, because you're breaking God's commandment. Right. That's why you don't have a husband. You probably have a boyfriend or whatever you may be. Oh, I don't have nobody. But you was created. Listen, if I ask you, are you virgin? You're not going to tell me anything because you've been living a whole life out here. But guess what? If you don't have a husband, then God not find you to be a virgin. There be something wrong with you. Right. You've been living a whole life. So it's time for you to repent out of that. Now, choose a husband. That's all. That's all we are about, the redeeming of our people. That's why they create their community single parents, our single sisters that working hard, have 3-4 kids. They have to do 2 jobs to support because their black man is not there. Their Spanish man ain't here. We here to win him back in the spirit of Christ.
That's right. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
Go ahead.
The God of our fathers,
the God of the Israelites. God is only the God of the Israelites. That's why they said the God of our fathers. The word our fathers means a set of people. The God of our fathers has done what?
The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom ye slew and hung on a tree.
Don't go no yet. Don't go no yet. Sis, come here, come here. You see, you giving me the finger. I have not shown you any hate, sister, for you to give me the finger. You want to talk to me? Do you want to talk to me? You want to talk to me as a sister and a brother talking? You don't want to talk to me? Why you don't want to talk to me? Because I'm here to tell you about you. You need to change. You never had nobody tell you about you?
Okay.
That's love. Oh, are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? I'm going to tell you everything about you. Give me Leviticus about that time. I'm going to show you everything about you. I'm here to show you you. You have not known you yet. I'm here to show you you. No, you don't know you. Because if you know you, today's the Sabbath. Today's the Sabbath. Today's the Sabbath. You would have stopped buying and selling. That means you don't know you. Because you are from the tree of Israel. You don't know you. So you're going to continue to be who you are. You're going to continue to be messed up out here and drugs, alcohol, all type of wicked things. Go ahead, sister, do you. But I want you to recognize something. Whenever the nation drop this nuke out here, guess what? You're going to be the barbecue. You're going to be burning. You understand? Get ready for that too. Because you got big mouth against the word of God. But there you go. You've been around this world. You look like you in the 20s, 30s. You have not learned nothing yet. But today is your day is where you're going to learn, black man. Stand up and be a man in your neighborhood.
That's right.
Not being a drug dealer or a basketball player or a football player. And stand up and be a man.
That's right.
You've been living a boy life too long. Wake up, be a man now.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.